guys, welcome to Trending, brought to you by Airtel. My name is Nancy Isime, and you are on to Trending, where we talk about things and people that are trending. Allow me to take this short break. When I come back, the show begins. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to Trending, brought to you by Airtel. Today on my hot seat, I have the one, the only, Jim Ike. So good to see you. How are you today?
Well, can't complain. Yes. Universe has been far too kind.
Amazing. Yeah. I already complimented you, but I love the blue, the black. Everything is looking really good.
Thank you.
But tell us on our style of this segment, what are you wearing? What is the inspiration behind it?
I think my mood swing with wardrobe. Basically, today I felt like blue. Yesterday I felt like red. No, I think it's a spur of the moment thing. Once I threw open the wardrobe, the one that beckons, I choose.
You choose. Mm. Amazing. You look amazing as
Thank
always.
You,
I know you already know.
Appreciate it.
Okay, so today we'll be discussing the topic relevance and sustainability in the industry, especially the Nollywood industry. For someone who's been in the industry for over 20 years and you've been in a lot of movies, what is that one thing you still put in as an actor in your films?
I think it's individuality and flair. Mm-hmm. The fact that once you recognize who you are, embrace it totally, learn to hone it, forge it, weaponize it, mm-hmm. and understand how to sell it to the world. I think that obviously is the crux of successes. That's how it's made. Another thing is to understand that consistency, obviously, is the way forward. You can't be all over the place. Mm-hmm. Like Jay-Z said in one of his interviews, you can't second guess yourself, you're surely once. Mm-hmm. So I think I woke up someday, I understood that down my journey, I'm going to be able to do many other things, mm-hmm. but there's one structural point, the pivotal point that will give birth to so many other platforms that mm-hmm. obviously will happen in my life, but I had to focus and make this one work first. Mm-hmm. Immediately it works, every other door opens.
Amazing. Now, I'll say over 20 years, but if you were to put a number to how long you've been in the industry, do you even remember?
It's far less than 20.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I came in, it was a cursory glance at first at what was going to be my lifelong pursuit. But I wasn't sure because there was also a career in finance I was pursuing. Mm-hmm. I studied this when I was really early in life. Mm-hmm. I finished college when I was about 20. So I was looking at going for my master's and consequently my PhD. And you know, that's I'm from the Igbo extract, obviously. And then you know how they plan your life from inception to when you enter the grave.
Sure.
So that was their plan, but you know, God's plan took place, and I just understood that this is my first love, this is what gives me joy, and I wanted to do this. Mm-hmm. So give or take, I think it's been 15 years, but I've taken so many hiatus in between.
Okay.
I went back to get my postgraduate, went back to raise my son, went back to take care of my businesses, and I think by and large, I've earned the right to come and go as I please, because paid my dues.
Obviously, you have paid your dues. Mm-hmm. And you know, one thing in Nollywood, I'm sure you'd agree, is for the longest time you were termed the Nollywood bad boy.
Oh.
You know, but how were you able to evolve away from this, you know, stereotype?
I am a bad boy. I can't change it, man. I'm not for lack of trying. I've tried, but you know, we agree that the common denominator is understanding who you are and embracing it. I'm bad, man, you know, but how do you define bad now? That's the question. There's a formal analogy of it where you obviously do run afoul of the law, you don't understand who you are, mm-hmm. you're totally averse to law and order, and you're just all over the place and just trying too hard to prove to people that you're just lawless, mm-hmm. you know?
Mm-hmm.
And that's a renegade version of it. Then there's a structured understanding of the bad boy image, okay? I don't do things in the box. I do untraditional things. You can't find me doing the orthodox. My approach to things will always be different. Mm-hmm. I don't belong to cliques or groups, mm-hmm. and nobody can understand how I move.
Mm-hmm.
And I think in that regard, it infuses my creative ability when you remain largely mysterious and unpredictable. And that, in a sense, It's been bad.
Mm.
What are you doing? The Michael Jackson bad.
Right, right. Mm. Well, you know, aside from being an actor, you recently produced your own movie.
Yes,
I don't know if this is the first.
No, it's mine. This is the third film we're producing, but it's my biggest effort so far.
Amazing. Mm. Bad Comments, that is. Mm. Tell us about it. Why now?
It's a tongue-in-cheek satire. I think it's a very relevant film.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted a common denominator, a film that even if you between 2 or 90 years old, you can easily resonate to this.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't want a film that was termed a Nollywood, a Bollywood, or a Hollywood film. I just wanted a universally viable film.
Oh, nice.
So we wanted to find a common denominator that cut across all creed, religion, class, and political affiliation, religious affiliations.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted a movie that anybody can walk in and enjoy, you know? And so we took time to get it technologically right. So it took a lot of resources. Bad Comment cost us 5 times our initial starting budget. But I didn't want to relent. That was the whole idea of going away for so long, so that when you come, it's about a statement. I didn't want partnership so much to get this done, and that's why I had to fund it myself, so that I alone would be responsible for whatever goes up or down about it. It's a relevant movie of times. It's a film about cyberbullying and the fact that there's a certain culture, there's a propensity that's going on now that it's becoming a vice that gives us need for a lot of concern.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost cool now to be culturally cruel. You understand? People go in and, you know, this cyberbully is going there and say the unspeakable to people's psyche and mind and totally destroy people's self-esteem, all in the name of participating in a platform that obviously is supposed to be a gift to the world.
Mm-hmm.
It's a conversation that is not being held in the right quarters. You will not believe that during our research for this film, I found out that young men between the ages of 15 and 19 are the most susceptible for suicide from cyberbullying. So people's lives are just being wasted for no reason because you don't understand the impact of your word on social media. You go out there and, you know, it become a place for projection of cruelty and hate for absolutely no reason because maybe you didn't meet your quota in life and you have a reason to hate from another person. Another reason we needed this was the issue of the narrative across the board. I needed an anti-hero, obviously. I told it through the prism of the celebrity whom is the worst hit in this regard. Are we really doing too much? Is our ostentatious lifestyle that we're throwing in people's faces, is the truth that behind is now we encouraging, are we motivating rather than offending? Okay, these are people that are working just as hard as you are, begin to question, you know, their motives in life. I mean, they have no reason them to be disgruntled because you're in their faces and doing these things. Are there far more elegant ways we can show our successes without throwing it in people's faces? And then on the other side too, of the regard, is it enough to hate somebody that's seemingly a stranger that you don't understand just because you can hide behind the veil of a typewriter and just say whatever you want? So it's a broad spectrum, it's a broad narrative. I think that all we're going to do in Bad Comment is offer perspective.
Amazing. Mm-hmm. Now, as an actor who's starred in so many movies, I feel like for us, when it's time to produce our films, it has to be different.
Yeah.
It has to be something that you've never ever done before.
Mm.
What is different about Bad Comments that no one has ever seen, you know, that this is a Jamaica that no one, I mean, already from the trailer, I can tell that this is a Jamaica I've never seen. But what is it? I want you to tell us.
Being in front and behind the camera is chaotic.
Mm.
It can rob you of your mind if you're not strong-willed. 1 minute, I'm in front of the camera making demands like an actor.
Mm-hmm.
Next minute, I'm the one behind taking the brunt of people's demand as a producer, executive producer.
Yes.
And so it's a dual sword that I had to bear, dual responsibility I had to bear. And trust me, with all these smaller projects, it was so easy to, you know, manage this. This is a huge project. We had 3 producers on this one alone. And three associate producers, you know, and so many assistants. Mm-hmm. So it's a huge project with a crew of over 85 at all times for 2 months. I just had to cater to with the ego, you know how it is with the so-called superstars on set.
He says another superstar.
So now you're on the receiving end. So I was like, okay, truthfully, it made me grow a lot more sensitive to producer's plight, a lot more emotionally, you know, sensitive to it. I'm like, damn, when I make these demands, forgive my friend, by the way, when I make these demands, this is what they go through to meet it. I know I had to do PGs for somebody who wants just to meet and set. We lost this set. I don't want to mention names, but I paid $1.4 million for a particular suit in West Carlton. The actor disappeared on me. Just like that. We paid 3 days, we lost 2 days, we lost $2.8 million just like that. And there's a part of me that couldn't come to terms with it. Yeah. And when this person came, the person was just so casual about it. And I had to call this person outside and say, do you realize what you just cost me? But I decided to manage the situation at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. And we did, and we're cool. We had to pay another one more day to do it. That's just a tip of the iceberg of what we went through. It's amazing. At the end of the day, the question is, you know, you lose your mind to this. This is what you signed up for. This is what makes you alive. Would I do it again? Hell yeah. November, we're going back to set to shoot another one. So, I mean, it's a life I signed up for. And I mean, that's it.
And it's so good to hear, because I'm sure other producers are watching and they're like, the next time we get you,
I'll be nice.
Oh, new generator.
I will be nice. I promise you guys. Somebody up there, like, second or third call me for a production yesterday. No management. I was like, should I get you? I said, no, madam, talk to me. I was so nice. I was like, let me check the number again. Jimmy's like, I said, talk now, madam. Nice.
I change out for you. Yeah. So that's good to know.
Yeah.
Now, in an interview, you mentioned that you're fearless, and that's what pushes you beyond boundaries. What are some of the things that, you know, this fearless nature has inspired you to do over the years?
There was a time after I had my son, I became really complacent in a sense. What you call the daddy mentality took hold. Mm-hmm. I became really comfortable. It was nice to know my business. We just established our first two portfolio, and it was going well, surprisingly. Mm-hmm. I expected a struggle, maybe because I expected a fight, pushback. I didn't. The business took off well. Everything was smooth. So I fell into the routine of raising a son, running my business, and living the everyday life. Mm-hmm. They say comfort is where most visions go and die. Mm-hmm. And I experienced it firsthand. I stopped taking risks. My lawyer was so happy. My banker was so happy. Everybody, my sisters were overjoyed. Oh, he's not climbing mountains anymore. He's not trying to kill himself doing bungee jumping. I even got a daddy car, man, and I got a van, you know. I'll do my run, drop him off, come back. So it was that lifestyle. And when I nearly killed myself and I didn't, that told me that, okay, so this is who you are. You can't change who you are. And when I survived and I went back up the bridge, that killed the whole fear. So sometimes it could be that extreme, right. But you have to be in that zone, you know, whatever it is that informs you that you're alive, that keeps the lion in you, the giant thriving and going. Don't ever get comfortable.
Amazing. Good to know. I mean, I obviously picked in some things here and there because I need it for myself as well. But let's talk about leadership. You mentioned leadership recently. I'd like to know, if you were made the president of the Actors Guild of Nigeria, what would you want to be done differently?
Well, hypothetically, that is likely not going to happen because I have absolutely no interest in that platform. But it's a damn good question. And I just believe that the guy that is there right now is doing a lot given the circumstances. Mm-hmm. There's a lot we need. People say that the banks and the financial institutions are not doing nearly enough for us. Yeah, while we inform a great deal of the GDP and we obviously set the pace for our economic appraisals, we don't do enough to structure our company into a proper establishment. I mean, the industry into a proper establishment. Mm-hmm. When you walk into a bank, the first point of interest is the ROI. They're giving you money and they want something in return. They want to understand that you are a bankable entity. Mm-hmm. And then we've not made that happen just yet. Mm-hmm. I think everybody's so fixated on the content, on the creative aspect of it, of superseding themselves and getting into the Hollywood space, that whole competitiveness and making sure it's a Netflix film. Mm-hmm. They forget there's a business to it. It's called show business, okay? Mm-hmm. They're fixated on the show way too much for far too long. Let them focus on the business. Let's bring the much needed experts. Let's push our government to promulgate laws and degrees that will safeguard our product, leave a legacy, leave our residues intact, and make that legacy, you know, viable for our kids, for our generation that are coming. Mm-hmm. So everybody is just playing the, keeping up with the Joneses game, the latest cars, the nicest houses, the dopest wares, and the biggest bank account. You forget that this is just very trivial part of the big picture. Mm-hmm. The big picture is establishing a strong financial base that is viable, so I can walk into any actor, any thespian of worth, can walk into a bank and take what he needs to expand his horizon, without question. Everything that's happening right now within the financial institution is all charity. They give you and they go and have a meeting behind the scenes and say, no, we're not expecting this money back. We know they're not going to do it. But that conversation shouldn't be held in an entity as big as ours. Mm. It's the second largest industry worldwide. And, there's just so much potential in here that's daunting. And I don't understand why people, and our country as a nation don't want to see down. Our leadership don't want to understand that the business, it's in show business. It's not only in oil and gas or agriculture. Those are all great entities, but it's also in show business. California is one of the richest economic base or cities in the world. Do you see any natural mineral resources there? No, not one. But they can compete with any city in the world. They are stupendously rich because of show business, because they paid attention to the natural talent of the people, to that natural industry, and then look at where they are.
Amazing. Amazing to know. Thank you for sharing that. What advice would you give? I mean, everyone is watching right now, but I'd want to speak to an actor who's watching his role model now. What advice would you give to him?
I think the whole narrative, the whole appraisal of what you stand for will change, and then you begin to assume yourself with a certain decorum, carry yourself a certain way, understand that you can impact lives. Okay, you're responsible for giving or taking dreams, and that's a lot to carry. And I think that is one thing that once they understand that part, getting into this field, every other thing, one way or the other, will fall in place.
Amazing. Thank you so much for sharing. Thank you. Hey guys, welcome back to Trending, brought to you by Airtel. I hope you enjoyed the video of the day. We still have the one, the only Jim Ike on my hot seat. And we are about to, up things a little bit. We're about to play some games. First off is our fast fire question segment. I get to ask you a couple questions about yourself and you just answer them really, really fast. Ready?
I don't like this, but let's go.
Under 60 seconds, of course. Time starts now. What was your first job?
I've never had a job. I just went straight from college to acting.
Okay. Your favorite cake flavor?
Cake flavor is velvet.
Okay. Yeah. How do you start your day?
Good prayer to God. Do my kata to keep my body in shape or mind, then I observe my 30-minute silence.
Okay.
Getting my mind right.
Okay. In which subject were you worse at school?
I was really a good student. I know everybody says this, but I was really a good student because I didn't have friends or hang out. I just study a lot. So I was really good in almost all subjects, except Hausa. I was forced to take Hausa and I hated it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. In which subject were you best at school?
I was very good in math and English literature.
Okay. What's something that you do not like doing?
I don't like drinking fizzy drinks. It really starts my day badly. I react badly. Fizzy drinks.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Have you ever been in love?
Yes. I've probably been in love twice in my life.
Okay. If yes, I'm not here with who? I'm not there.
You don't really know who. My two kids.
Okay. We're going to move on now to the tribe where I get to ask you a couple social media abbreviations and you just give me the full meanings.
I promise you I'll fail.
You try. Okay, first one, BTS.
BTS is behind the scene.
There you go. TBT.
Throwback.
Yes,
Tuesday.
Thursday.
Throwback Tuesday.
Ah, nice.
Okay.
Okay, I-C-Y-M-I.
I-C-Y-M-I. Oh, I give up.
In case you missed it.
Oh, in case. I couldn't have gotten that one. So I'm going to give up on time.
Okay, IDC.
IDC. I don't care.
There you go. Mm-hmm. Last one, I-K-R.
I know, right?
Yes. There you go.
Okay.
Well, you did so well. Really, really well. Well done.
Yeah, thank you. How did I do?
Very well. You literally got like 90%.
Wow. Okay. I didn't expect that.
Amazing. Welcome back to Trending, brought to you by Airtel. I still have G. Mike on my hot seat, and he's about to read some nasty comments. Please read and respond the best way that you can.
Someone is producing a movie every guy, you know, when you call yourself a man, you got like Tina, the gym has always been a growing mature, they will always brown trash and they will come back. Wow. This is
now you fix this segment.
This is an amazing person. And trust me. I can only say something to you. You're on the point of suicide, that's for sure. Anybody that's so this sad with himself is waiting to die. Please find me. I got money and I'll sponsor your obituary. let me try this a second, and that's why that's true. I'm very rare, but I can promise you the reason you are this bitter is because your daddy probably beat your mom. Okay,
because that's how did we get there?
This level of sadness. Are you guys still there? Let me deal with mom.
Just two.
I guess it's only two that tried me. Thank you.
Ready. Nobody's ever ready like this. I swear. Now you fix the segment. Alrighty, guys, it's a wrap. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for sticking with us. Of course, I had Jim Ike on my hot seat. I had a lot to talk about, of course, laugh about. I hope you enjoyed the show. If you joined the show, join the conversation. Follow us on Twitter at Heap TV, on Instagram at Official Heap TV. You can also follow me on Instagram only if you wish at Nancy Isime Official. Until I see your pretty faces next time, I love you, but God loves you more. Bye bye.